Hey, by one students, Prashant again, day three of notes. We're going to talk a little bit about sex-linked traits with genetics. Years ago, a guy named Thomas Morgan, which isn't that important to you guys to know, but he was doing some experiments and he kept coming up with these traits that were only showing up in males, not females, which kind of defied logic a little bit. It didn't make much sense to him at the time. Because Punnett squares don't really tell you if it's boys or girls. It just tells you, here's the odds of getting this trait or that trait or whatever. So sex-linked traits were discovered because he got to thinking, what's the only chromosome that would be different that would allow males to get something and not females? Well, that's the X and the Y. Females obviously have two X's and females have an XY. So what he figured out is sex-linked traits are traits whose alleles are located on sex chromosomes. We do have X-linked ones on the X chromosome, about 100 traits. That's what we're going to talk about today. There are some on the Y. I'm not going to say there's not, but with Y-linked traits, mutations lead to sterility, so they're not passed on, so we don't discuss them in genetics, all right, because they don't get passed on. So he came up with this term, X-linked and sex-linked. They mean the same thing, so that's a good probably A, B, both questions on one of my tests coming up here. What are sex-linked traits? What are X-linked traits? So basically, they're traits that show up in one sex and not the other. So let me try to explain this a little bit. Hemophilia is a great example of this. Hemophilia is a blood clotting disorder found in males. Females have never got hemophilia. And it's a terrible disease because every time you cut yourself or bruise yourself even, because that's internal bleeding, if you don't have a clotting agent, your blood doesn't clot, doesn't scab over. So people with hemophilia, if they cut themselves, they got to go get a blood transfusion because they'll just keep bleeding. I don't care if you put bandages on it, gauze, whatever, it'll just bleed. And you have to go get a blood transfusion with seven different people's blood in that. So the other problem with hemophilia, it also became a disease back in the 80s that most people, most hemophiliacs got AIDS with it because of the transfer of HIV. Now, we test blood better today, not the case today. Okay, so we have to do a little different Punnett square with this one. So this is what we do. It's always XXXY. It's always a four-box Punnett square. This is the only Punnett square that not only tells you what traits you get, it also tells you what if it's male or female. Okay, so with this one, you can see here's how this works. So you got a female that is normal, but she has this little H, hemophilia gene, which means she's a carrier. Okay, and the male has the big H, so he's normal. So both of them are normal pairs, but look what happens. You get 50% or all the 100% of the females will be normal. One will be a carrier, but normal. But with the boys, 50% of them will get hemophilia and 50% of them will not. Okay? Not good. Okay? So that's how Thomas Morgan figured out these sex-linked traits is you can see that it gets the X can block in a female and prevent it from happening. You don't have that luxury in a male. Okay. They're going to 50% of the time, they're either going to get it or not. There's no blocking because there's nothing on the Y. So when you do these Punnett squares, just be very careful. Don't put any traits on the Y. The Y is just there to tell you the sex of the offspring. It does not show you, there's no other, don't put anything on there because it doesn't affect it. All right. Now, hemophilia is actually kind of interesting. It's actually traced back to the European bloodlines. You can see that actually these are four royal families. There's actually England that you hear about all the time, William and Harry and Meghan Markle and all that good, Kate, okay? This is the Austria, Russia, and Czechoslovakia. So there's actually four different royal bloodline, royal families in four different countries in Europe. And You can see where, or Germany, my fault, not Czechoslovakia, Germany. So Germany, Austria, Russia, and England. Okay. And you can see how here Queen Victoria was the original carrier. She never had the disease, but look at all the males that end up with it in three of the bloodlines. England got lucky and didn't have any in their bloodline, but all three other royal families have it. Okay. And that kind of leads me into what this is. This is called a pedigree. Okay. A pedigree is a family tree of genetics. It's a chart of genetic history of a family over several generations. It shows you how things are passed from one generation to the other. So think of it like a ancestry.com, basically a pedigree. All right. That's kind of what I want to show you today. I'll kind of go through the rest of the pedigree stuff tomorrow in notes, and we'll call it good. So, hey, as always, if you got questions, shoot me an email. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you later. See ya. Bye.